What's up guys, it's the Hunter Project here. Welcome to my channel where you'll find Monster Hunter news, builds, playthroughs and everything in between. If you could smash the like subscribe buttons, it would be extremely appreciated as we make our way to 200 subscribers, hopefully by the end of 2020. That is the goal. And we're not too far away, but we do have a little bit of time left. So if every single person watching could smash that red button, there is still hope and I appreciate it so damn much. Don't forget to join our Discord server, link is at the top of the description. We've got around like 21 members now, so it's growing at a really good pace. And yeah, without wasting any more time, let's get right into the video. So guys, today we got some Monster Hunter Rise information via the Monster Hunter Twitter account, and it was pretty cool details, nothing too flashy, but it was new information nevertheless. So getting right into it, we were given three of our new main NPCs that we'll be interacting with constantly over our Monster Hunter Rise experience. So of course, these aren't extremely new, we have been introduced to who these characters will be, but we did get some new animation, so I just wanted to go over the three again. Starting off with the first one, we have Kagero, who will be our shopkeeper. Excuse the pronunciation if it is wrong, as obviously I'm not Japanese and I don't know Japanese, so I'm just reading it as I see it. And yeah, he will be our shopkeeper in Kamurao Village, and he has a pretty cool design. It's very different from the previous merchants, as expected. Capcom have not released any details about what he will sell, but it's obviously safe to assume that it will be a very similar stock to our previous games, with him selling items such as potions, whetstones, barrel bombs, and everything else we have come to expect. He will of course continue to sell coatings and ammunition, so all the gunners and bow mains can buy their beginning ammo before they have the resources to create builds that require them to like combine materials to get their stronger ammunition and dish out more DPS. He will also have a function to be able to be on sale depending on a specific quest that you can complete daily, and it is a timed sale, and this comes along with the new lottery mechanic as well, which they haven't spoken too much about, but it is pretty much aimed at players with less money. One thing that is not clear though is whether or not Book of Combos will be making a return, as of course the only one game that it didn't appear in, at least as of recent times, was Monster Hunter World. But assuming that it's still branching off of World's design, which it clearly is, I assume it's probably not going to make a return, and I think they have gone to a more streamlined experience where you don't have to worry about having Book of Combos 1, 2, 3 just so you can craft Mega Potions successfully and Shock Traps successfully, which is good to see because of course that was a bit annoying having to carry like Book of Combos 1 and 2 just so we could craft certain items, or in some cases 1, 2 and 3 or whatnot. But regardless, I doubt it's making a return, but we'll see if we get any new information on that or when the game releases in general. The next NPC we have is Hamon, who is going to be the Hunter's Blacksmith. So we will be crafting all our weapons and armor from this guy for our Hunter. He has a really cool design, white hair, old man type character. However, he will not be crafting armor and weapons for our Palico and Palamute, which brings us to our third NPC that was being introduced, the feline Kisaki. This is very similar to past games where we had two separate NPCs to craft armor and weapons for Palicos and Hunters, which is different to obviously World's type of design where we had one character who dealt with everything from our Palico's armor and our layered armor and everything in between. And yeah, of course there is not going to be much change in terms of what these guys do, and of course their stock's going to obviously depend and correlate to the monster list of the game. However, we may see some new things such as maybe Palico and Palamute augmentation, or even layered armor, but obviously that is off the top of my head, so don't take any of this information as confirmation. This is just me more just throwing ideas out there, but we don't have long to wait until the game releases, or maybe they'll even release some new footage. And regardless, by the 26th of March we will have found out what's new to our blacksmiths of the game. So this does bring us to the end of the video guys. If you did enjoy, be sure to smash the like subscribe buttons, it is extremely appreciated as we make our way to 200 subscribers by the end of 2020 hopefully, fingers crossed. We are so close and I thank you guys so much for the support. Don't forget to join our rapidly growing Discord, which is at 21 members now, which is amazing. Link is at the top of the description. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.